And the scary fact is that tobacco use is the leading cause of preventable disease and death. But quitting smoking can be one of the most difficult things a person will try to do. But there is help, and it's completely free. Joining us live in our studio this morning to tell us more, we have Mr. Mike Rogers. He is CEO of the Smoking Cessation Trust. First of all, thank you for being here.
Glad to be here.
People make their New Year's resolution all the time. People always need help trying to fight the addiction to tobacco. Tell us more about this free help to help people kick the habit.
Well, the Smoking Cessation Trust was set up by a court case, a judgment against tobacco, and it funded four Louisiana residents who have began smoking cigarettes prior to September 1st, 1988, a free program where our company will fund their cessation treatment. So they can get quitline services, they can get some doctor visits, group counseling, as well as the pharmaceuticals that their doctors might want to put them on to help them get off of the addiction.
How successful is it? We know it's a 10-year program.
It is a 10-year program. We've started in October, actually, taking members, so it's kind of new. We don't have a lot of evidence behind our program. However, nationally, it takes about six tries before you can get off of the nicotine addiction. The good thing about our program being a 10-year program, once you're a member, you're a member. So if you need to take six times, you can.
I see. And when you talk about...
It's completely free.
It's completely free. That's what we love about it. So many people affected by this. 45% of Americans make the New Year's resolution to stop smoking. 88% of them will fail at keeping them. What's shown the most success in helping people kick this habit? You hear about the patch, the gum.
Yeah. It's a combination of things, actually. Yeah. And that's the court ordered us to use an evidence-based program. The evidence suggests that a combination of coaching, which is telephonic most of the time, group counseling, which there are some programs in Louisiana. Those are growing every day. We're getting more and more of those. And then a combination of those things with medication, it has shown to be the most successful at helping people quit.
Statistically, how many people in Louisiana are smoking, and how young are the smokers?
Well, I'm not sure about the age distribution, because our program's limited to people that started smoking prior to September 1, 1988. So it makes them in the 35-year-old and older range. Uh-huh. But I can tell you we have roughly 400,000, a little more than 400,000 people in the state that smoke. About 200,000 of those fit our class. Mm-hmm. That means the other 200,000 are probably younger than that.
Wow.
And they do target the younger.
I was about to say, we know tobacco companies have a history of targeting young people.
Well, you grow them young and they continue through adults. So you sell them when they're young and they tend to continue.
Yeah. All right. And it's all about helping people stop smoking. Tell people how they can find out more information.
Well, the easiest way is go to our website. They can sign up on it. It's easy to remember. It's smokefreela.org. Or they can call one of our phone numbers, and I'm terrible at the phone numbers, but I'm going to try it. It's locally 529-5665, and then we have an 800 number that I can't remember to save my life.
I never
call it.
You don't have to, right?
No.
The information is on your screen. For more information, just log on to www.smokefreela.org. Thank you so much, Mike Rogers, CEO of the Smoking Cessation Trust. Thanks
Thank
for being
you.
A part of our